Beatitudes. The Beatitudes is about the assurance that God is with us. God does not condone injustice and oppression, because at the other side of the Beatitudes, if you go further in the reading, he will also say, woe to you who are rich, woe to you who are happy now, woe to you who are able to show your power over others. Being blessed means that God is your protector. God will protect us. God will be our shield. God will be our savior. And so in our Mass today, the Lord tells us, well-being or health or blessedness is not dependent on having the completion or completeness of everything. Instead, being blessed is to recognize that in the midst of your poverty, in the midst of your loneliness and mourning, in the midst of your struggles, God is with you. God saves us, and he gives us hope, and he gives us something to look forward to in our life. Ang pagiging blessed po, mga kapatid, hindi yung nasa iyo na ang lahat. Ang pagiging blessed ay ang makilala at makita sa buhay mo na kasama mo ang Diyos at yun ay sapat na. You will not have a perfect life, but you will have a perfect God who journeys with you. Sa misa po natin ay pagdasal natin na sana makita din natin na blessing kahit yung sakit. Because in the midst of your pain and due to sickness, the Lord assures you that He is your healer. Na makita din po natin na kahit hindi kompleto ang gamit sa bahay, blessed pa rin ako kasi alam ko hindi ako pinapabayaan ng Panginoon. Na hindi tayo na-approve sa visa, blessed pa rin ako kasi baka may sinasabi ang Panginoon na dito ka muna. Na hindi tayo pumasa sa bar exam o kung anuman na exam kinuha mo, hindi ka pumasa, blessing pa din naman yon kasi baka naman iba rin ang direksyon na pinapapuntahan sa iyo ng Panginoon. To consider your losses, to consider your imperfections, incompleteness as a blessing. That's what Beatitudes is all about. When we realize that life is not about perfection and completion, that life is about being filled up by the love of God in the midst of the many things that are lacking in my life. Minsan sa ating pong mga tao, tingin natin hindi tayo blessed. Buti pa sila, blessed ng Panginoon. Ang dami nilang biyaya. And you look at your life and you feel so miserable because compared with others, you don't have much. But the Lord assures you today, He favors the lowly, the despised. He chooses the weak in order to shame the strong. He chooses those who are not so knowledgeable in order to shame those who are arrogant. And He tells us, I am with you, and because He is with us, we are complete more than you'll ever know. You are blessed, doubly blessed, because God is your comfort, consolation, shield, protection, and hope. Yun po ang blessing, mga kapatid. Hindi kompleto ang lahat, pero kasama natin ang Diyos at hindi tayo pababayaan ng Diyos sa lahat ng mga pinagdadaanan natin sa buhay. And this, I would like to tell you and would like to end with this. When you consider and see and recognize that in the many tragedies of your life lie hidden the blessing of God, then you are truly blessed. Pag nakita mo na nasa gitna ng iyong mga luha, na may pagpapala doon sa likod ng iyong mga pagsubok sa buhay, yun ang Beatitudes. When you are able to transform your tragedies and frustrations into gratitude and grace, then you are truly blessed. When we are able to integrate the cross in our journey. It may not be perfect. It could be full of struggles and sufferings. But you see the love behind the cross. Then you are truly blessed. A person who is truly blessed is not someone who is living a picture-perfect life. A truly blessed person is someone who recognizes that everything is grace. Lahat ay biyaya. Kahit ito man ay karamdaman, biyaya pa rin ito. When sickness becomes your friend and you tell your cancer, "You were given to me, I will embrace you fully. How I wish you would go away, but if you would like to stay, welcome, cancer. You are my friend. How I wish you would go away, but if you are given to me, I will befriend you." That's what Beatitudes is all about. When we are able to see that the cross is part of the journey, when we are able to see that life doesn't have to be perfect, that family life doesn't always have to be problem-free, that when you are able to integrate the quarrels, arguments into that beautiful family dynamics of love and humility and acceptance, then you are blessed. So don't look for a picture-perfect life. Look for a blessed life. And a blessed life is made up of both the good and the bad, the shadows and the light, the cross and the victory of the new life. So today, I invite you, dear brothers and sisters, look at your life and you say to the Lord, "I don't have a perfect life, Lord, but I'm truly blessed because of you. You complete me. You are able to give sense and meaning to my sickness. You are able to see me through all these hardships and adversities. And you, Lord, you make me blessed, not the other things that I have." Pakisabi nga sa katabi natin, you are blessed. You are blessed.